Hello guys, my name is Fox and welcome to part 4 of our Princess of Darkness campaign in Crusader Kings 2. Let's continue. So, in the previous episode, we've been doing just some wars, conquered this one province, we had like a de jure claim from one of our counts or dukes, or whoever you are. Yeah, you're a duke actually. And this episode we're also probably just gonna continue conquering. We currently don't really have any borders with someone we could attack, really. Because this Ventru guy is probably too powerful, as well as this one, who looks like an abomination. Kind of possible that we could attack this Nosferatu guy, but what I thought we might do is just instead conquer like these smaller guys. We don't really have any CB on them except extort tribute or establish tributary state, but it's fine. I'm completely fine with just making them my tributaries. They're still going to be able to join my war. And they're going to be providing me with some gold, allowing me to bump up my capital and all the stuff around it, so it's gonna be completely fine. And yeah, I don't think there's like much stuff in here we could do. We're gonna be learning some more of these abilities, but yeah, not much else. Probably gonna do some embrations as well, so let's just go on and pause. We also have like access to some people around here, but I've looked around, it looks like they are werewolves. There's quite a few werewolves around, so if I were to declare like a jihad on them, it's gonna be kind of dangerous because all of these guys gonna join and I might have a difficult time. We also still have land in here, by the way. Oh, we could attack someone like you. We have the border dispute CB as well, but it's gonna cost us piety and gold. And it's probably unreasonable. Unreasonable price for one... for one province. What's your religion? In corner. Okay. I have no idea what that is about. And how many supporters you might have if I were to declare a jihad on you. Do you have any duchess or something? You are Duchess of Brabant. So this thing. You're supposed to have a de jure claim on that. Yes, you do. So I might go and just vassalize you for now. We should be able to reach you. You have 600 troops and no allies. Yeah, I'm just gonna declare a war on you for now. De jure claims are pretty easy ones. So sure, let's go and do that. It's gonna combine you like in Prague. You guys might be useful as well. You need to stand down for now because you're probably gonna get smashed. I'm also gonna call in this Nosferatu. And also, a good thing about having the tributaries in this mod, at least in particular, because it looks like our characters are pretty much immortal, so it means they're gonna stay our tributaries forever, because the only way tributary could break free is on the death of the character. So yeah, we're gonna basically have forever vassals, so that's probably what I'm gonna do with all of these guys, just make them all into tributaries. No need to conquer them. It's gonna be a little bit a little bit not good because actually they're still gonna provide us with their armies by joining the wars, so yeah, it's just perfect. Oh yeah, I'm a lunatic, that's good. We got lost some prestige out of it, that's fine. So your army is here, I'm gonna tell you to attach, that's fine. And yeah, let's just go straight for this thing. Oh, you actually brought your army here, that's good. I'm gonna give you a battle and then we're gonna go and siege down the province we're looking for. Where have you went? Probably somewhere in this direction, right? I have no idea, but I'm just gonna go straight for your province. Unfortunately, our capital got pillaged in the previous episode, so it's kind of weak. She's probably gonna be able to siege it down. Oh. Okay, have you just disbanded your troops or something? Or are you just running that quickly? I have no idea, but here's your army is now in Brabant. I'm just gonna give you a battle. We're suffering some attrition for being out of our lands for too long. But we're about to get into friendly land again. What is that? I have procured irrefutable evidence that this man consorts with Canaanite heresy. Yeah, burn him. Sounds like a fine idea. So we're gonna give you a battle. Should be a lot of war score. 30%, not bad. Nail is gonna give you a siege. If I remember correctly, we had like a siege general, right? Or we had like no generals. Maybe it was a different campaign, or maybe he's already dead. We also need a new hound. Sure, let's go and make you into a hound, because you're a vassal. Just so... Hopefully you're not gonna join any more stupid factions, because we have... Yeah, also, one of the positive things of having tributaries is that they are unable to join independence factions. So just all bonuses, all pluses, so... Yeah, that's probably gonna be the way to do this campaign. So, why are you rebelling again? So it's probably the guys who are just recently conquered, right? No, you actually were the part of my realm from the start. And yeah, now you want to rebel, even though I gave you some extra land, you stupid bastard. Yeah, 60 opinion of me. Oh. Weren't you the one who I pressed claim on? Maybe the previous guy just died. Maybe that's why you're such a jerk. Okay, I forgot about these guys' existence. We're just gonna disband them. Also have some special troops. Yeah, let's go and bring them in as well. Kenick, so violate the silence of blood, revealing the vampire. The masquerade has been breached. What shall be done with the Kenick? Okay, so that's some special event. That's interesting. So my vassal just broke the masquerade. So, make Senec forget. This option is available because we have dominate free. So, Counselor Camilla Banes' opinion of Kenick changes. Kenick gets confused. Kenick gets stressed. Loses nose too much. Oh, Kenick is just a human, right? Okay. Knows too much. This mortal has seen too much of the world of darkness and knows something of the honors to walk as knight. Okay, ignore him for now. Bribe him or kill him. Yeah, let's just go and dominate him and see. Sure. Your hunger grows. Okay, so we use some blood for that. But at least, yeah. That's actually basically how you deal with humans in the world of darkness. At least that you try. You might just suck them dry, but it's fine. And I'm not really sure if Malkavians have anything special with that, but yeah. Has violated the sense of blood, remember, blah, 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 the masquerade has been breached. Oh, so now what we need to do is, yeah, Jan, or forgive for a favor, forgive, okay, you, for some reason you're not showing the name. Let's go and forgive you for a favor. And looks like this event is probably broken because I did not receive a favor from anyone. Okay, that's fine. At least it exists, so that's fine. And quite interesting. Okay, so I guess these troops were... No, this is the same ones that I've beaten. They just came back. Okay. Princess Marta Sunta, Ethel of Pressburg, is trying to usurp my title. Yeah, let's make him disappear if possible. How can I rely on my generals when their understanding of warfare is so lacking compared to my own? I could teach my duke to become direct leader. Yeah, let's go and do that. Sounds like a great idea. Also, do I have any commanders whatsoever? No, let's go and set us out assigned commanders. Yeah, that's better. That's better. So, now, do we have anyone with special traits? Doesn't look like it. So there's no, probably no reason to place you in here. If you're not gonna be speeding up the siege in any way. So, would you be able to siege down my capital? Yeah, because it lacks levy. And maybe because it was burned down, I don't know. You might actually have a chance. Yeah, you're doing pretty good. But I think you might consider surrendering after I'm gonna siege down one or more, or one or two of your holdings. Yeah, you might even surrender like right now, as everyone else does, right? No, okay. I guess I'm gonna let you siege down my capital. I hope you're not gonna be able to imprison me because of that. Because I still think I am at my court. But yeah, it would be really unfortunate if I were to get imprisoned. Okay, you did siege down, but nothing terrible happened. Okay, this guy is a part of a faction, right? Yep. So, we could obligate him or do nothing for now. Let's go and try to obligate him. Very good. So you should now leave the faction. Hopefully. Also, the guy who liked me left the faction as well. That's a good decision. Because otherwise I would have probably killed you. Maybe not. Okay, we got enforced demands now. We're gonna become her vassal. And it's all fine. So we could stand down troops now. Have some special ones in here. So let's go and bring them back to our mainland. And yeah, I'm probably gonna try to expand in here, as I already said. Just gonna do a whole bunch of tributaries. And I'm also pretty sure that if I were to declare tributary wars, that no one gonna be able to join their defense except their allies, and they have none. Your vassal is concerned about non-inheriting sons. I don't care about your sons. I'm not gonna give you any lands. So, how's my hunger looking? Yeah, looks like the hunger is actually going away by itself. I don't understand why is it made so. Because I'm pretty sure it's not how it works. In the like World of Darkness, you probably like have to feed to replenish your blood, but who knows? Don't know too much about this world. So I could spend some points. Yeah, let's go bump up like retinue limit. In here we could get like sure burger influence, and in there I'm trying to bump up renown to be able to establish tributaries, right? So and considering that established tributary. Oh, you're in the part of Tremere now. Oh no, you're actually independent. Nice, do I have a CB on you? I could make you into my tributary. And you have only 400 troops. I probably should do this. But yeah, considering that establishing tributaries does not allow them to join my wars, it might actually be better for me to just go and use this one CB, extort tribute on everyone. And yeah, this type of tributary will break free upon the death of their suzerain. But considering that we already lived for like 500 years, I don't think we're gonna die too soon, so... That's quite great. Yes, Should we start with you? Doesn't really matter. But yeah, why not? Let's just go and extort tribute from you. We're gonna be... Hey! Why couldn't I call you into this war? So apparently establishing tributary is not a good enough war for you to join in, but I still have enough armies to deal with that by myself, but yeah, that's a little bit upsetting. And you decide to surrender immediately. That's a wise decision. A lot easier for me to deal with. So how is it now gonna show? Okay, it's just gonna show Malkavian in here. Yes, it's a little bit ugly. Excuse me? Ah, that's why I couldn't call you in, because you broke free. But it says on it breaks free on the death of the suzerain, but looks like your previous guy died, and now you're not. That's strange. So, this tributary will break free upon the death of their suzerain. I'm their suzerain. So why the hell you broke free if your ruler died? It doesn't say it in the rules, but sure, okay. We need to get you back under our control, but you actually have a pretty sizable army, which I do not like. Do I have access to any mercenaries or anything? I do, but I cannot support them. Okay. Let's go and wait a little bit for our armies to replenish, because if they were to fully replenish, we're actually going to be relatively fine. Stop trying to usurp my title. It's gonna try to kill you again. Excellent. At the age of 108, you died. Yeah, that's what you get for trying to usurp my lands. And while we're actually on that, we might just go and like bribe, not bribe, but... Also, what's my marshal up to? He's not doing anything. That's not right. Also, could we have a better marshal? We kind of can, but... Not too much better, so I guess I'm gonna keep you. You need to be training troops in my capital, because you're not replenishing quickly enough. Yeah, I might consider doing some pillages, probably. Like in some more Tremere land. Also, could we conquer this Nosferatu guy? If we were to get this one as our tributary, there is a possibility that it might be able to tributarize you as well. We only have 2,000 troops, and we're gonna have more if we were to combine properly. Also, apparently we have a de jure CB out there as well. Okay. Who are you the part of? What is that? Sundao. Just like spread around a little bit. Okay. Could spend some more tech points. Yeah, let's go and bump up our renown again. I mean, like level 4 to be able to use this CB. Kind of a little bit too much. But oh well. So, how quickly are we replenishing? We're not replenishing as quickly as I'd like to. Do these guys provide me with their... no, they're not actually providing me with their labor reinforcement, which is a little bit unfortunate. But money is always good too. According to your sheriff, Richezer Novitz, the peasants of Hradech are having frequent troubles with highwaymen and wild beasts. Yeah, let's go and build them some whatever they want. By the way, we could get an upgrade in our capital as well. So how about we're gonna get you like a keep to increase the size of the army? You realize that to become a great fighter, you would need to get in better shape. Yeah, let's go and try it. Okay. Why do you have this thing? This ambition if you're a scholarly theologian. I don't know, but you became brave. And that's actually a good idea. Ah, probably because I have war focus. Yeah, that's probably why we got this event. Okay. Should we or could we learn anything else? I could get animalism too. And looks like you could use some of your abilities in this flavor events. Like we've used domination to cover up the break of the masquerade. So maybe it's gonna be useful for something else. What animalism gives me right now? Animalism 1, intrigue plus 1. Okay. So I could learn animalism 2. Do I need prestige for something right now? Probably not. So let's just go and learn it. Why not? Yeah, my hunger grows. You have bloodthirst. Okay. That's fine. So, animalism 2 gives me intrigue and stewardship. Okay, that's cool. How's our army looking? 1600 troops. What are you looking like? 1500. I think we should be ready to attack you. We're just gonna do that. I don't want to wait too much. We're gonna use extort tribute again. Yeah, to establish tributary state, we need renown tech 4, which is crazy. Yeah, I'm just gonna try to extort tribute. Gonna raise all the armies. Try to combine you like here. That's fine. Might as well try to get these guys. But probably not going to happen. Also, you have 500 troops. Yeah, I might as well go and call you in. Just in case. So, would you be able to catch these armies? Doesn't look like it. Okay, that's good. Yeah, you might as well go and try to siege down my capital. Also, you girl need to attach to my armies. Probably gonna be more efficient this way. And yeah, let's gonna give you a battle. Who are you? Yeah, let's gonna reveal the plot. So, we do have some leaders. I am not leading the armies myself. Not gonna make this mistake twice. Let's wait for this girl to attach to our army just in case. And then we're gonna go and attack. Okay. Yeah, that should be a pretty easy battle. Let's hope you're not gonna finish off the siege. Yep. Okay, flanks are doing fine. Yep, you're gonna smash you, no problem. And that's good. Are you ready to surrender yet? I invited people in my court to take part in a war game. Cool. Yes. Let's go and do that. At the beginning of the war game, the enemy quickly tries to advance up the hills in the area to get strategical advantage. Bring all forces to contest or rush forward with light skirmish before their force reaches the hill. Let's go with the skirmish. Arus decided to charge forward with his troops toward our skirmish troops, forfeiting the opportunity to get a position on the hills. Ale found produce just that we should intervene and engage the enemy. Try to flank, rush forward to help, or use cavalry to cover the skirmisher's retreat while taking the hill. Let's try to flank them. And apparently I lost. With our troops being split up and exhausted, we cannot fight the united forces of Rus. We failed to... Okay, that's fine. It was not a real game anyway, so I lost some prestige. And that's all good. And I'm not entirely sure that this event even has a direct outcome. It's probably randomized. I have not looked into it, but... Yeah, you guys actually don't even need to stand... Don't need it to exist anymore, so it's gonna stand you down. And also, it was my timer already, so I am going to take a break in here. And we're gonna continue the next episode. So, if you enjoyed watching this, you could leave a like. If you want to see more, subscribe. And if you want to leave a comment, definitely do it. And I would answer it since I could. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.